YouTube. It is such a marvelous, wonderful day today. And I'm here to give you all the correct perspective on the news, all the wonderful news of everything that is going on in this world today, and all the things that affects us and brings and leads to our happiness and gives us energy. And we have all the energy that we can hold and all the energy that we could use today. And I want to tell you where you can get it and how you can get it, and how you can get into the vortex, like this great, wonderful book says here, Getting Into the Vortex Guided Meditation CD with user guide Esther and Jerry Hicks, The Teachings of Abraham. We all need to get that book and read it and all the other fine books and learn how to get ourselves into that vortex. And I want you to look at this wonderful smile here this morning by this lovely lady and realize and think about how we should all feel that way as we're waking up this morning. We should feel just like smiling just like that. And I'm so proud to display that smile because that's the way I feel all day long, just like that. I don't want to look silly on here, or I'd be grinning from ear to ear all the time. But I want to, when I'm talking about something like this on here, I don't want to be doing that because people would just say, well, he's just being a little bit too silly. And so I have to control my ecstatic emotions. And I am the spirit of ecstasy, but I can't get on here and display everything that I would have on my countenance when it comes to the happiness and the spirit of ecstasy, which I have all day long, because I have to be able to mouth the words of what I'm teaching you. And so I do control the expressions on my face somewhat. But I feel just like way she's smiling there. And I feel that way from the time I get up to the time I go to bed because of this wonderful world that we're living in. And if you listened to the debates last night, you wouldn't have heard any of that, though. There's nothing coming from either one of the candidates or anybody else or the reporters or the announcers or any of them in that debate or any of the other debates that displays that they have a clue of what is happening in this world today and what will be happening, especially in the next coming days. We're living in a world which is changing, a world which is mushrooming toward higher consciousness and toward marvelous things, toward a huge amounts of multifaceted amounts of abundance that is waiting everyone as they get into the vortex. And we should say that the news is the vortex. The news is the vortex. And the news is however you want to define. There's hundreds of millions of people that have studied this book, but then there's millions more that have that are in the vortex, but they call it by different names. But whatever name you want to call it, divine metaphysics, if you want to call it divine mind, if you want to call it cosmic consciousness, if you want to call it infinite mind, we need to get in that. And that's what's happening. This is a new age when people are getting into what they call the infinite mind, what they call divine mind. They're learning divine metaphysics. They're learning cosmic consciousness. They're learning I don't get into astrology and things like that, but those that are seeking into that area there are seeking also to raise their consciousness. It's just a more limited form of consciousness, in my opinion. But all of these things, at least, whether it's astrology or whether it's the galactic federations or whether it's ascended masters or whatever it is, all of these people are seeking to raise their consciousness. And when you start adding up how many people are involved in all of these things, how many millions and millions, then it's easy to see what the real news is. And the real news is that planet Earth is beginning to turn into an abundant planet due to all of these myriad forms of consciousness raising. Some of the forms of consciousness raising, as I say, get to the vortex faster than others, but they're all heading in that direction of mutual abundance among all the people on the face of this earth. And that is the real news. And all of this name calling and things like that to try to get somebody in some position has nothing to do with what's really what's happening in the world. And so there are infinite spectrums of energy, power, strength, and healing, healing love, joy, and peace within the mind of our source, divine mind, God. It is all available to our consciousness and our lifted awareness today, right now. Right this minute, it is all available. There's nothing that is not available. Get you a notebook and get one this thick and write down everything that you'd like to see available. Write down everything which you want to demonstrate, everything you want to manifest. And then when you get that notebook full of all that, know that all of that is now infinitely available, and you need to stand up, raise your hands, or whatever you do as your form of expression of happiness, and begin to shout out in joy and rejoicing that you know that it is all present now. And you need to rejoice just like everything in your notebook of dreams is correct right this minute, because that and 100 million times more is here now, and that is the news. It is all available to our consciousness and our lifted awareness. We have to take time to reflect, though, on this fact, and then let the substance and energy of it fully saturate us and fully embody us. And we need to get into a state of intense awareness, a state of intense meditation upon the omnipotence, omnipresence, and omniscience of infinite mind, and begin to let that totally imbue us with all the great power and energy and healing power and enrichment power and wealth producing power and creative power and ever important power which you could possibly want. It's all found within infinite mind, our vortex, and it's all found within our source. We must ask then to be anointed with the true, real, and substantive flow of divine wisdom and energy. John 7:38 says this all in certain words. Other things say them in different words. But the words of John 7:38 says, "He that cometh unto me," and remember Jesus has said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Being the infinite mind has all of the way to your abundance, has all the way to your love, has the way to your joy, has the way to your peace. The truth has all the truth that sets you free, way, the truth, and the life, all the abundance of life, being all the quality of life, and all of the purpose in life, and all the motivation in life, and all the interest in life, and everything, the way, the truth, and the life. He that cometh to that, Jesus said, out of his innermost being will flow rivers of living water, rivers of all divine power and energy, rivers of all healing power will flow from our innermost being as we begin to come into that. That being you could call that also the vortex. Getting into the vortex, he that gets into the vortex out of his innermost being is going to flow wealth and power and authority and energy and healing power and all the rest of it. It is already totally ready right now for you. It's already for you. Today is full of humongous energy because it is packed full of the omnipotence of God, infinite mind, our source. And omnipotence, of course, this means all power. This means all power that saturates and imbues the universe. A marvelous thing to wake up to and realize. The news we need to wake up and realize is that infinite power and authority and love and joy and peace saturates and imbues this entire universe. And all that awaits, all that is necessary for us to have that flowing in our life is just simply to open our mind and let it flow. Open our mind and let it flow. Oh, how could we have a better setup? How could we have better news? How could more wondrous things? How do people have time to get up on a stage and denigrate one another? How do people have time to argue about mundane, picayune, powerless, limited things when they have such power and authority that they could turn to if they only would? The wisdom is being overlooked. All the wisdom and the strength and the intelligence intelligence of our mind is being overlooked while we're just denigrating one another and jockeying for our position and trying to get just a little bit higher some small finite ladder in some corporation or something, or in some political forum, or in a political situation. But there's no limit to this energy extent. What a mess that debate was. That was the biggest mess, that debate. last night that I've ever seen, just nothing but a circus. No real wisdom or education or learning or intelligence being displayed whatsoever. Nothing that you could really pick up that will help you in your life or help you to understand politics more or understand the government more. There is no limit to this energy except our awareness of its presence. Anytime that we need more energy or creativity, all we have to do is look to our source, which is totally infinite. And let me get... It is very important to know that we are perfect, complete, accepted, and loved with an infinite amount of unconditional, pure, full, and total love, and that we are inseparable from God, our infinite love, then divine mind, our infinite source. We are inseparable from infinite love and divine mind, also known as our infinite source, also known as the vortex. We're inseparable from that vortex, but we're unaware of it. We're actually in the vortex, but we're unaware that we are. And so getting into the vortex is getting into the awareness of that great vortex which fills the universe and which we can get into at our infinite source. Divine mind only awaits our awakening so that we can be filled with everything that is mentioned in this book. And there's a whole lot mentioned in this book. Believe me, you need to get it and read it. We need to realize that we are inseparable from this and have all-encompassing immortality. We can totally be imbued with that immortality, and it will give us all kinds of healing power, and it'll lift us up in all kinds of health and healing, and healing strength and healing energy, and ability to be healed of whatever disease, a cancer, diabetes, a heart disease, whatever you have. It's only a small, minute thing compared to all the vast amounts of energy which is there. And that's real news. That's what people need to get on the news and be announcing instead of all this name-calling and jockeying for position and things like that. They need to get on there and begin to announce how that all of the power to be healed of cancer, heart disease, diabetes, anything is all really available. If we'll only lift our awareness to the trouble of all of it is that with it, there's no trouble with it, but the trouble that people create with it is they don't want to take the time necessary because they don't believe if they take the time necessary to receive the healing that they'll actually receive it. And so it's not in the fact that we can't be healed, but it's in the fact that we won't take the time to get quiet and meditate and receive these truths. As you raise consciousness to see the now reality of all this, then look at 1 Corinthians 13:4-7 again and see if it does not make a lot more sense to you, where it talks about love is patient, kind, and never vaunts itself up and all this. Well, we can gain that through meditation. We can gain a love and a wisdom and an infinite strength and an infinite healing power that just becomes patient and understanding of everyone and patient and understanding of the sick, and we'll be able to go and cause them to be healed by giving them the truth, and we can be patient with it, and we can understand it, and we can not fear it, have no fear of illness or anything like that, and be able to work with the patients like we should be able to. Stop being fooled and affected by fear and lack, and let your love flow. You have an infinite amount of it. Don't let the false ideal of limitation cause you to hold back your natural immortality from expressing itself fully. Because it is for sure that if we feel limited and mortal, then 1 Corinthians 13:4-7 is almost impossible to recognize that patient love and that healing love. That healing love is that patient love that's talked about there in 1 Corinthians 13:4-7. And we can have that if we will get into the vortex like we should and begin to receive from infinite mind. And so y'all begin to study this book, and then we'll get back to you on the next video.